Hello students, good morning. In your previous period we learned how to add the numbers, okay, then after how to give a format of your cells, that is your addition of your cell columns, cell rows, deletion of your rows, columns or cells. These topics which we learned in your previous period. One more topic which we learned in your previous period is that it is about your how to insert a picture also. Okay, this was the topics which we learned in your previous period. Now today onwards we are going to learn how to do calculations, that is how to add this total marks. Addition has been already given, explained you, that is just for your two columns only. Now today I am going to show you how to do the addition of more than two columns. Okay, so already three columns I have prepared for three subjects, that is a computer, SS, science, and now third one I am going to prepare, that is a max. For max I am going to enter 22, 25, 26. Now it is just a random mark, that's why I am going to drag it. Okay, so right now I am having total that is your four subjects, that is your computer, SS, science, and max. Now instead of roll number I am going to add the name also over here. Name Parth, Shyam, Sanjay, Mahesh, Karthik, Vinod, Abhish, Shek, Arjun, Vikas. So these are the names of my students, random students I am taken. So now the thing is that I want to know how much marks, that is how much total marks each and every students are getting. For that purpose what I am going to do, I am going to total it. Now totaling is always done by using the formula which is known as a equal to. Okay, either we can use each and every time, that is your equal to sum bracket open. Now what I will be doing, I will be manually entering each and every cell name, that is a which in which cell this is in a C3, 35 marks in C3. So I will be writing C3 plus. Now next is about your D3. Then after, if I want just two numbers, just write D3 and just give an symbol, and you can see 60 is being given. Okay, so what I have done, C3 over here, you can see if it is not visible, just see over here equal to sum C3 plus D3 I have written, that is your D3. Now each and every time if I want to add plus, now E3 also, that is a science marks E3, then again I want to insert max marks also. Okay, so for max also what I will be doing, I will be doing max is a F3, then after giving enter the value is not given. Wait, equal to sum B3 plus C3 plus D3 plus E3 plus F3, bracket close, enter. Sorry, I have made a mistake. That is here. I don't need to write B3. That means B3 is the name. Okay, so C3 onwards my value should be starting. C3 plus D3 plus E3 plus and last one is your F3, bracket close. Now you can see the value as 114. Before that I have made a mistake. I am accepting that. The mistake was that I have started from B3, that is a B3 which will be becoming, it will be becoming the to Parth. So okay, so this is a mistake. Parth is not a number, it is a name, so it won't be calculated. So I want just as a number only, so I have to calculate. This was the first method, that is a what I have done, equal to sum, then after C3 plus D3 plus E3 plus F plus F3. Then after giving an enter symbol, automatically you will be getting the total. Now the thing is that each and every time we have to write this, so there is a shortcut method. What I will be doing, equal to, this is a second method, okay, equal to sum, bracket open. Now if I want to calculate from here roll number second, so I will be selecting this by using my mouse, okay, then bracket close, bracket close, just give an enter. Understood? Two methods are there. First method, equal to sum, write down equal to sum, bracket open, then after we have to write each and every time, that is your cell address. Cell address means, if I'm writing third roll numbers, that is your C5 plus D5 plus E5 plus F5 also, then and then given bracket close, just given enter, automatically you will be getting the total. This is your first method. Second method is a shortcut method. Just write the same thing, equal to sum, bracket open, then after select the cells which we want the total. What I have done, see, I'm selecting it. Can you see after during selection, see in my total, during selections, see over here, see I'm selecting it. Now you can see C5 to F5, that means from C5 to F5 already it has been selected, bracket close, and just given enter, totaling has been done. This is your second method, and what we have done over here, I've just dragged from here this plus, after at the edge of this cell, just select that particular cell, at edge of this cell just drag it, automatically each and every cell will be functioning the same formula. Okay, so in this roll number also, fourth roll number also, C6 to F6, in your fifth roll number also same process, C7 to F7. In this way I am getting the whole total roll numbers. Understood? Now next is your mathematical functions. For mathematical functions, which is in your seventh chapter, this is the seventh chapter we are going to start. In seventh chapter, first thing, that is your ABS, for getting an absolute value, for getting an absolute value we will be using the function, that is your equal to ABS. Okay, if I want to get the minus 30 absolute value, I'm written as minus 13. Okay, so if I want to absolute get to know absolute value of minus 13, bracket close, just give an enter. See, that means any a negative number will be becoming the positive by using the absolute value. Can you see over here what I have done? Absolute value is 13, minus 13 I have given, and by using the formula, that is your equal to ABS, and then the selecting the cell also we can use it, then after just give an enter, automatically you will be getting the value which is known as your absolute value. Understood? The next is your exponential value. Exponential value means exponential value, if I'm writing as it will be getting the 25's exponential value equal to exp, then after I'm selecting the value of exponential which is to be inserted, give an enter. This is my exponential value of The same way, if I want to get the exponential value of 1, just give an enter. See, automatically this formula is being inserted over here. So I have to change the number only. If I want to get the exponential value of 5, just give an enter. If I want to get the 6, see, can you see over here changes is there? If I want to get the exponential value of 7, see, can you see the changes? That means automatically if I'm writing over here and here, the value of this cell will be changed. Here also same process. If I'm writing the value of 25, here also 25 is there. If I'm writing the value as minus 15, we can see 15 is there. Okay, now in this way we can change the value. Now next is about your power. Now power means, suppose if I'm using the value of n equal to value of n, I'm taking as 10, and the value of power equal to value power equal to 3. Okay, now and I'm taking the formula, that is equal to power. Okay, I'm going to select this thing and this thing, bracket close, you can see 1000. How this 1000 has been came? Now as you know that in max we used to write 10 raised to 3. Okay, the 2 raised to 6, if I'm writing over here 2, if I'm writing 6, you can see the value is 64. Okay, 2 raised to 2, you can 4, that is 2 raised to 2 means 2 2s, that means 2 will be multiplying with 2 times. Okay, so in this way if I'm writing is 3, you can see 8, that is the 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. Okay, so this is the value of power. Automatically what I have done, I have taken the value of n as 2, okay, and the value of power is 3. Okay, now it means 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is my value, that means 2 raised to 3. So 2 will be multiplying by 3 times, 2 into 2 into 2. So what happens? 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. The answer is 8. If I'm writing over here as 4, automatically it will be coming to 16. Why? Because 2 will be multiplying 4 times. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. In this way, I'm getting the power of n. Understood? So this is your mathematical calculations which is used in our 7th chapter, that is in your specially calc. Okay, I hope you all understood today's topic. Today we learn how to use the totaling by two methods, that is your equal to sum and the value of each and every cell address. Okay, in this is the first thing. Or else we can use equal to sum from starting to ending. Just drag your mouse, automatically you will be getting the value of or the total of each and every cells. This is the two things which these are the two things which we learn in your totaling function, that is your sum function. Now next is about your absolute value. Absolute value means converting your negative numbers or positive numbers to positive numbers. That is, if I'm writing over here 15 minus 15, automatically my absolute value will be 15. If I'm writing over here minus 100, here I'm getting the value as 100. Understood? Now exponential value means it will be getting the exponential value or mathematically exponential value of each and every number. The exponential value of 1 is 2.71, whatever number is. If I'm writing the value of exponential value of 5, see, you can see the value of exponential value of 5 is 148.4131. understood? See, 6 value as 403. Now last topic which we learned today is about your value of power. That means for getting the value of power, what I have done, I have used two columns, that is a value of n is 2 and power of value of power is 4. So what happens, 2 will be multiplying into 4 times. That is your 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, and 8 2s are 16. How many times I have multiplied? 4 times. So answer I am getting is 16. Now if I'm getting using 8 and value of power is 2, say 8 will be multiplying 2 times. That is your 8 2s 8 8s are 64. Okay, don't think that 8 2s are 16. No, 8 will be multiplying by 2 times. So over here into 3, so you can see 8 8s are 64. 64 into 8 is your 512 answer. Understood? So this was your today's topic. Okay, so in next period onwards we will be doing the further mathematical calculations. Thank you, students.